Hi friends, welcome to my channel and today I will discuss with you accrual basis and cash basis of accounting. So before we begin with, I would request you guys to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any of my videos. So let's get started. Firstly, what is the meaning of accrual basis? Accrual basis simply means that you record all your revenues, your cost, your assets and liabilities for the period in which they accrue. Supposedly, I'm preparing my accounts, say for the period 2019-20, right? So whatever my income and expenses for that period, whether I have received them or not, I will record it. This is known as the accrual basis. I will explain you this with the help of the example further. This method is also known as the mercantile basis of accounting, right? This method is also known as the mercantile basis of accounting. Further, we have another method, that is the cash basis. This method is very easy because we record all the actual receipts and actual payments made in the year, irrespective whether we've accrued this in the same year or not. Whatever we've received in cash, we record it, and whatever payment we've made in the cash, we record in the same period, right? We have the differentiation between the two, the accrual basis and the cash basis of accounting. In this, we say first difference is prepaid outstanding expense, accrued, unaccrued income. Whether it is of the current year or not, right? So we have to make the adjustment of the same in the accrual basis. But for the cash basis, no such adjustment is required. Why? Because we are only concerned with the cash receipts and the cash payments. That is it. Right? And in case, what we will have, whether we will have higher or low income in case of prepaid expenses and accrued income. Now, what are the prepaid expenses? Say I'm preparing my accounts for 2019 and 20, right? Prepaid expenses, I have made the expenses, I have already paid the expenses of the year 2020-2021, right? So what do? I deduct my expenses. From the expenses, I deduct my prepaid expenses because I have already paid in advance. But this is not for the current year, right? And for the accrued income, I have earned that income, but I have not received it. So in the income, what do? I add this accrued income. So this will result in higher income in my accrual basis, whereas my cash basis will show me the lower income, right? Similarly, what will I have? Whether I will have lower or higher income in case of the outstanding expenses and unaccrued income. Now for the outstanding expenses, they were to accrue in the same, they are occurred in the same year, but I've not yet paid it, but still it is my expense. So what do? I add on my expense. And unaccrued income, I have received it, but I've not rendered my services for the same. Right? So I deduct my accrued income. So this will show me low. Now the third kind of method is also there, that is known as the hybrid method. Okay, or the mixed method. What do? In this, incomes are recorded on the cash basis and the expenses are recorded on the accrual basis. That means in the year which they are occurred. So I will explain you all these with the help of an example. See over here, I have fee received. 60,000 is my fee received. My income is 60,000 and all other are my expenses. In terms of salary paid, rent, magazines and journals, traveling, and then membership fee paid, office expenses, so on and so forth, right? So these are my expenses and only one source of income is there, that is the fee received. Further, we have the additional information that fee includes 3,000 of the previous year, that is 2012, and fee not received is 7,000, right? Office rent is 4,000 of the previous year and 2,000 not yet paid, and membership fee is paid for the 2 years. Over here, supposedly if I have to prepare for the cash basis, what did we study? That on the cash basis, what do? We simply do it on the cash basis, received or payments on cash basis, right? So whatever it has been made on the cash basis, we record it. So we can see the fee received in cash and all other expenses, right? Simply we've recorded that and we've not made any of the adjustments. In cash basis, we do not make any adjustments. So the difference between the income and expenses comes your net income, right? Now the next method that we have to do is the accrual basis. In accrual basis, we need to make the adjustments, right? So the first adjustment says that we include 3,000 of the previous year. So we are preparing the accounts of 2013, right? So the fee of the previous year needs to be deducted, right? Because it has been accrued in the previous year, so we are going to deduct 2000 from the fee received. It also says that fee not yet received is 7000. We were supposed to receive 7000 in 2013, but we have not yet received it. So what do we do? We will add 7000. Why? Because this fee 7000 is of the 2013. So we are going to record this in our accounts. So let's see. The same adjustment has been done. See, we have taken the fee received, that is 60,000. Then we have added 7,000, that was of the current year. And we have deducted the 3,000, that was of the previous year. So net comes to be 64,000, right? So there was no adjustment in the salary, we can see. Okay, so no adjustment is there in the salary. So we are going to record 8,000 as it is. Next adjustment is of office rent. Office rent, it says that 4,000 is of the previous year. So what do we do? We deduct the 4,000 from rent paid. And it also says rent of 2,000 not yet paid. But we were supposed to pay it because it is of the current year. So we are going to add 2,000. So net will be what? 12,000. So let's see. Our net office rent is 12,000 over here. What do we do? We add on the rent that was due and of the previous year we've deducted it, right? I hope there's no confusion. Then over here there was no adjustment for the magazines and the traveling expenses and the office expenses, but there is an adjustment of over here is a membership fee, right? Membership fee there. That is for the 2 years. For 1 year, it will be 800, right? So I have written 800 over here. I've taken 800 only. So difference between incomes and the expenses, I will get my net income. I hope you've cleared till here. Okay, so last method is the hybrid method. In hybrid method, what did I tell you? We record all income on the cash basis and all the expenses on the basis of accrued. Right, on the accrual basis. So over here, what is my income? That is 60,000. 60,000, we will do it on the cash basis. Right, over here you can see no adjustment has been made for the fee received. Right, and what did we study about the hybrid method? That all the expenses have to be made on the accrual basis, right? The adjustment needs to be made. So whatever adjustments we made on the accrual basis for the expenses will be the same in the hybrid account, right? Office rent that was added because we were supposed to pay it, and office rent of the previous year we've deducted it, right? Similarly, membership fees that was paid for the 2 years, I've taken it only for 1 year, and the difference between the income and expenses is my net income. So I hope you've understood all the methods of accounting, that is cash basis, accrual basis and the hybrid basis. And if you guys have any problem, you can comment me in the comment section. Thank you and have a nice day.